you know, there is something compelling about discovering your family tree.
Isn't there, though? It's interesting finding out who we are and where we're from. In short, what makes us, us.
And now it's easier than ever with loads of companies happy to take your money and your DNA in return for a breakdown of your genes.
It certainly seems straightforward, but is it? Most of us have become very relaxed about giving away our personal details, like our address or credit card number. Now, for roughly $100, you can send off a sample of your DNA and find out a raft of information about yourself.
I found out that I was 96.7% Cypriot.
I actually gave my kids ancestry kits for a birthday one year.
There's nothing to hide. I mean, you are who you are.
There was some negative impact on taking your DNA and using it in other types of research.
There are more than 200 companies globally that offer mail order DNA tests.
They might start doing ancestry, but they might move into health, or they might offer paternity tests. There's also growing talent tests, which are quite concerning, and infidelity tests, which are less well known, but really quite worrying.
That's right, send off a small sample and you can find out if your partner's cheating on you or if your child is a budding Mozart. Here, though, we're probably most familiar with ancestry testing. If you're interested in tracing your family roots or finding a long-lost relative, it can be a really valuable tool. What I want to know, though, is how accurate is it and just what information can you expect? So I ordered tests from two different companies, two of the big players. Each cost roughly $100. One was a cheek swab and the other I had to spit into a small vial. I sent them off overseas and 7 weeks later the two results arrived. We'll share them soon. The whole process was all very straightforward. Just tick a few boxes and you're away.
Voila.
But is that a good thing?
For the most part, these contracts are very one-sided and unbalanced to the detriment of the consumer.
Yes, often the contracts are very long and at times very complex. By sending your DNA off, you could be agreeing to all sorts of things.
You'll see things like a clause that gives you very broad power to alter the terms. So sometimes even something that says we can change our terms at any time without notice.
Let's be honest, not many of us really read the small print. Dr. Angelica Phillips does, though. In fact, she's literally written a book on it.
Your data could end up with law enforcement. There have been examples of it being accessed by the FBI. Some companies have already entered into partnerships with insurance companies. And then there's sharing with the pharmaceutical industry.
Before I'd even received my ancestry test, one of the companies sent me a deal to do a health test as well. So using the same DNA sample for roughly $100, I'd get information about my risk for developing the likes of heart disease, breast cancer, type 2 diabetes, etc. I didn't take them up on the offer. The thing is, the jury's still out on just how useful those tests can be. Take this recent study looking at rare gene variations. It involved DNA from 50,000 people, and the researchers concluded mail-order DNA tests are more likely to be wrong than right, which is especially alarming for the women who booked in for preventative mastectomies based on false positive tests.
If you couldn't rely on it and take it to a doctor and have it actioned, then I really question how useful that is to a consumer.
As Dr. Phillips said earlier, some DNA outfits are teaming up with insurance companies, which means there's potential for those health results to be shared further than you realise.
I have seen examples where if you look at the contract, it says something to the effect that if you have a test with them and then you don't reveal that you've had a test to your insurer, you may be committing some sort of fraud.
But what about those ancestry tests? Surely they're not so controversial.
It's enabling you to get through brick walls. It's enabling you to discover cousins that you've lost contact with.
Genealogist Fiona Brooke has been researching family history since she was 9.
You click on the button and you find all these people, and it was just goosebumps right up my arms right from the start because these people are related to me.
Let's explain quickly how it works. The tests don't look at your entire DNA. That's really inefficient. Humans share 99.9% of DNA anyway. So what these tests do is look at snippets of your DNA where the differences are likely to occur. That means it's possible you'll get different results from different companies. What you can also get, assuming they've been tested, is a list of family members. And that can be really exciting, unless you find out something you weren't expecting.
So I guess the biggest thing is maybe discuss it with their family, especially if maybe they've heard rumours or something like that, and maybe they've got elderly parents that this could open up a can of worms.
As for me, my results didn't open up a can of worms, thank goodness. Both connected me with family members, some I know and some distant cousins, but lots of family names popped up. As far as the ethnicity results go, though, well, you be the judge.
Test one told me I was 40% Scottish, 22% Samoan, 19% English or Northwestern European, 12% German, 5% Tongan, and 1% each from Norway and the Baltics. Test two, on the other hand, put me as 47% Scandinavian, 29% Polynesian, 21% Italian, and nearly 3% Finnish.
Right, they are quite different, aren't they? Not likely that it's a mistake. I think it's just what they call the testing populations and where they're testing.
We asked the companies for an explanation. They told us...
Each company uses different reference populations, different algorithms, and different methods to determine the ethnicity estimate.
And that...
Ethnicity estimates can be a result of comparing your DNA to a reference panel made up of over 40,000 samples from people with a long family history in one place.
Our advice? Make sure you go in with your eyes wide open.
Think about what you're comfortable with your data being used for and with whom you're willing for it to be shared.
That exclusive resort from our Baltic/Norwegian/Italian correspondent, Pippa Wetzell.
Now look, regulations to protect your privacy, they do exist, but putting them to use can be tricky. Our expert's calling for more oversight in the industry. She says, generally speaking, the price of DNA tests has dropped substantially.
Now, these companies are keen to accumulate as much data from as many consumers as possible. That's good for their bottom line in a different way. You see, they have partnerships with other entities like insurance companies and pharmaceuticals.
So if you are contemplating getting your DNA tested, please make sure you think about it carefully, not just for use today, but also for the future.